Hey crew, I've got the key to that 2022 Hummer EV Edition 1. We are going to take it for a drive, but first let's check out how it looks on the inside and outside. Like the Humvee H1 and H2 before it, the Hummer EV is extremely wide, 7.25 feet wide, about the same width as a Ram TRX or Ford F-150 Raptor. That width is emphasized by this LED daytime running light bar that goes across the face, spelling out Hummer EV. And at the corners, we've got sequential turn signals that when you're charging the vehicle, show the status of the battery. Below that are your LED headlights. You've got this sparkly black material, GMC badge, giant recovery hooks in black, steel front skids, and all Edition 1s are painted in this interstellar white color. Down the road, the Hummer EV will have additional colors. In profile, we find a set of 18-inch beadlock capable wheels wrapped up in Goodyear Wrangler Territory Mud Terrain 35-inch tires. With the equipped off-road accessory package, you get things like these LED spotlights at the corners and steel sliders with integrated step-ups. Like all excessively wide vehicles, we find those three orange lights here mounted high on the Hummer EV. Stepping back to look at the profile, this is going to take a minute. It's 18 feet long. This truck, so mighty, meaty, macho, other M words. I want to take a sec to thank Suburban GMC who are letting me review their Hummer EV, and I think they have four of them. So if you want one, I'll put their info in the description. Here at the back, your charge port door bids you access to level 2 charging, or pull this out for DC fast charging. And the Hummer EV has a maximum charge rate of 350 kilowatt hours, so you can add 100 miles of range in just 10 minutes if you can find that charge rate. The LED tail lights look pretty darn swanky. Hummer EV is spelled out on the Multi-Pro tailgate, so it has similar features to other GMC trucks, so you can bring the whole thing down and have easier access to the 5.5 foot bed with the spray and bed liner, multiple tie-down points. This one is taken up a lot by this optional spare tire carry, so you can bring your 35-inch tire with you. There are LED bed lights and a 400-watt AC outlet. You can also turn this into a step by pulling this down for easier access. Or when you have it all the way up, you can just bring this piece down to maybe have some lunch up here, or to secure things like 2x4s, like that. It's pretty cool. Your hitch receiver is here, and the Hummer EV can tow 7,500 pounds, not as much as the Rivian R1T or F-150 Lightning, but it's still pretty good. Optional recovery hooks in the back as well. I mean, are there many cooler pickup trucks, period? Of all electric pickup trucks, this is by far the most BA, but I mean, it's like overall, TRX, F-150 Raptor, and this, they're all conversation starters. Let's look at the interior. Opening up and looking inside at this light gray on black interior with a mix of perforated leatherette for the inserts and this canvas-like material for the borders. Like most conventional pickups, you can lift up the seat bottoms. And like most GM pickups, you can pull open the seat inserts for hidden hideaways. That two-tone theme continues onto the doors with that canvas material. There's this bronze tinge for some of the inserts, and then you get the knurled finish for the handles. Some hard, scratchy plastics in places, don't love that. I do love the Sea of Tranquility theme for the Bose 14-speaker sound system for these speaker covers. And that goes with the lunar design theme of the Hummer EV, showing NASA's ties to GM, with GM helping to engineer the Apollo 15 rover. So you see more of that moon topography on the all-weather floor mats. Got your step and then a grab handle to get in. Sitting behind my own seat at 6 feet tall, I've got good knee room, not excessive. Good sized foot pockets though. The higher floor from the battery pack means that my knees are pitched up at a little bit of an angle. The headroom is generous. And you can have infinite headroom when you take off each of these four removable roof panels. Pull that and that lever on each of them, and pop them on off. I also love that GM thought ahead and put markers on each of the panels so you're not gonna confuse them. There is a third zone of climate control, rear seat heating is standard, two USB ports, one A, one C, big cubby in there for storage, and an AC outlet in the middle. Sliding into the middle seat, I can fit here. That means you get full-size adults in all three of these back seats. If you don't have one sitting there though, you do get an armrest, padded, with two cup holders. You've got all you need in the second row. Now let's check out the front. Don't miss the frameless windows. Nice solid thud to that door close. Up front, we now have heated and ventilated chairs with Hummer EV on this bronze tinged backing, 12-way power adjustable seats, more of that lunar topography, including for the middle pass-through. Here we've got controls to open the front trunk, where we find 11 cubic feet of space, very generous when not occupied by the four removable roof panels that do fit inside. There's bed lighting buttons, bed power, and then you can hold this for all four windows to drop down. You get the same two-tone theme, Hummer EVs embossed on the door now. The Sea of Tranquility adds a moon boot for the front speaker covers, four one-touch windows, two-position memory, power folding, and power-adjusting door mirrors. There's another grab handle to get inside. More bronze tinge for these vertical air vents. I do like those. When you close up the door, you get a little animation on the 12.3-inch gauge cluster and the 13.4-inch touchscreen infotainment. And when that's completed, we'll power on the truck. This gauge cluster is reconfigurable with the different design themes. And then this screen is operated by the Google Android operating system. It's quick to respond. Occasionally for some of the animations, there is a lag, but I do love the graphics. More on that during the drive. There's both wireless Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Below the screen are these textured toggles to control your HVAC settings. I much prefer tabbing these to touching the screen. It's less distracting. Same deal for the heated steering wheel, for the front and rear locking differentials, and the traction control. This trim piece is not in gloss black. It's not going to smudge and scratch nearly as much. This satin gray, it does sound a bit dinky. Under here, we find two cup holders. Under here is a wireless smartphone charging pad and two USB ports, one A, one C. Very substantial gear selector. Neural dial for your drive modes and for your air suspension settings. Spot up here for your phone. Canvas wrapping with contrast stitching on the console, where we have two levels of deep console storage. On the passenger side is an Edition 1 plaque with a bronze surround. 3D effect is rad, along with the hidden moon boot right there. Pull this tab for the digital rearview mirror, and then you've got one here for the full-width power back glass. That's going to be useful for folks with surfboards or 2x4s. Visibility in this cabin is pretty good. You've got a little blind spot at the C pillar and B pillar, but thankfully there is blind spot monitoring with rear cross traffic. This cabin, I'm a fan. I like the different colors. I like most of the different materials, the lunar theme, the Easter eggs. It's getting me excited for the drive. Let's go take it. All right, let's fire it up. Some strobe lights on the Super Cruise steering wheel, some mild startup chimes, and what I think is the sound of a wood gyro, the musical instrument with the ribs on top of it. And now, we're in charge of 1,000 horsepower. A lot has changed in the Hummer's generations. No longer do we have the sound of a V8 gas engine or diesel, we just have a wood gyro. Before we get moving, let's look at the driving range here. It says we've got 291 miles of range. That is equivalent to about 88% of the maximum range of 329 miles, and that's exactly what this truck showed when I picked it up from GMC, of suburban GMC, this morning. I then drove about 35 miles, a lot of highway driving, which is an EV's typically worst scenario for maximizing range. And so I'd say that consumption so far is pretty on par with what you're supposed to see in this truck. Drive modes, we'll select that here. We can see some of the very cool animations as we go through the different modes. And these all come from Persuasion Studios, the brand behind Marvel movies and their animations. And the software behind the system comes from Epic Games, the company behind Fortnite. So with our drive mode selected in normal, I'm then going to go into reverse. This is still so creepy that the truck is on. And now that brings up a high resolution backup camera, and you have so many different angles to choose from. And if you want to get into some of the off-road views, got the bird's eye view, of course, ignore the awful parking job. It's hard enough to fit this thing in a space. I just didn't even try this time because no one is around. We also have some camera angles coming from under the truck, looking forward and looking back. Then have your bed view, which is totally taken over by that giant tire. And let's back on out. Oh, digital rearview mirror. Can't forget that. Now, typically, I start these POV drive reviews with a turning radius test. I'm going to do things a little different today because I don't want to waste any time before we go over one of this truck's most now notorious features, and that is crab walk. So to activate that, you hold down this button here until we see crab walk, which is really cool animation, fully accepted on the system. Then it shows the underscreen view, and when I turn the front wheels, the rear wheels are going to turn in the same direction. Now that typically is something that's reserved for higher speeds to give you more stability. Here, it's intended to be used in off-road settings. So I'm turning the wheel. This is so weird. And I'm moving diagonally. This is diagonal driving. And I gotta tell you guys, I've driven so many things. That is one of the weirdest sensations I've ever experienced behind a wheel. Behind the wheel. Now, the idea here is if there's an obstacle that you can't really maneuver around easily, you can kind of just skirt around it that way. Clearly, we're not dealing with an obstacle. I'm just doing this for fun. Then you hold this button again. It'll disengage crab walk. Goes back to rear wheel steering auto. And then we're going to do a turning radius test because crab walk's cool. You know what's a practical use of this? The rear wheel steering system? That's going to be the turning radius, which is incredible. Let me show you. That's not a lot of space, especially not for a giant vehicle like this. I'm going to crank the wheel. And we're not just going to make that. We're going to make that by about 2.5 feet. It's hard for me to press upon how crazy that is. This truck is almost, it is like 8 feet wide with a long wheelbase, and it maneuvers better than some subcompact cars. It takes something this daunting to look at and makes it so accessible. We're starting off so well in the Hummer EV. Let's hear what those turn signals sound like. That's so important. Very light knocking. Gentle. Horn test. The world famous. Let's do it right here. I like that horn. That is a pronounced horn. Let's you know we mean business. If you didn't, you know, see the giant truck approaching you, may not have heard it. So, 1,000 horsepower, how do we get there? Three electric motors and a 212.7 kilowatt hour battery pack. 1,000 horsepower. 1,200 pound-feet of torque-ish. GMC says this actually makes 11,500 pound-feet of torque, but that's the multiplied wheel torque. That's not really an accurate measure, not certainly not how we communicate torque for most vehicles. So 1,100 to 1,200 pound-feet of torque, that's the real number for you. Those are big numbers. This is also, for the 10th time, a very big vehicle. And it's heavy, incredibly heavy, 9,600 pounds. It's just got so much weight from those battery packs. But it doesn't feel it. It's actually just so easy to drive because of that instant electric torque. Apart from it being so wide, the steering gives me enough feedback that it's easy to keep it between the lanes. Of course, if you weren't paying attention, which you should always be paying attention, if you weren't, you might drift out of your lane. But it's pretty darn easy to drive. The ride quality is fantastic too. This adaptive damper setup is so good at muffling the road imperfections. Now, the body of the truck does creak. I mean, you may have heard a little bit of it already. And you feel sometimes, not feel as much as hear, the crashing of the truck over some really hard impacts. Is that an H1 right there? There's an H1 over there. Look at that. It must have known we were coming. Hey, and it's the pickup. Yeah, so the wheel kind of like creaks when you're using it at low speeds. That's a bit disconcerting. I can't get over how easy this is to drive. This is just crazy. But it's also incredibly quick. Should we do a 0-60 test? Let's do it. Now, in preparation for our launch, I needed to pull off to the side because there's actually a couple steps I have to do, including double clicking. That's cool. The traction control button. This is to engage Watts to Freedom mode. I'm gonna hit continue. The vehicle is going to lower. And now it's ready. You just hold your foot hard on the brake, pin the throttle like a normal launch control system, but let's wait till we get up to the light. Okay, I'm ready now. It says to floor it. It's also vibrating my butt while I'm doing this. Floored. Whoa! That's literally all I can say right now. Whoa! This is the craziest sensation. Oh my God, 3.4 seconds. Just breathless right now. That was insane. Geared up, held itself, released. Tenacious acceleration. Just unreal velocity from nothing. You could hear those all-terrain tires. It did it on 35-inch all-terrain tires. You could hear those squeaking so uncomfortably. Oh my goodness. This thing's a marvel. And I'm not just saying that because, you know, Persuasion Studios from Marvel did the animation. This thing is actually ridiculous. 3.4 seconds to 60. That's very, very quick sports car territory. and we just did it in a 9,600-pound mega SUV. And the theatrics that go along with the Watts to Freedom launch are really pretty fun. The seat vibrations are weird, you get used to them. But the noise? Gotta move my phone charging. The noise is wild. And this is what I'm looking for from EVs targeted at enthusiasts. I want some of this theater. I want some of this fun. And GMC is giving it to us. It adds to the excitement. It adds to the anticipation. I love it. I love this. Oh, that's a good time. How are the brakes? Let's do a test from around 60. Let's get down to 60. Okay, we're here and... Yeah. We're now a little bit into the crosswalk. Those brakes are fighting against the force of physics. You gotta give them the benefit of the doubt there. 9,600 pounds, bringing that to a stop, even when it's super low down, just an object in motion wants to stay in motion, and these outside forces acting upon that momentum have a lot to overcome. Now, I will say, the pedals stayed with me. It didn't completely go to jello. It mushed a touch, but I did feel like we were coming to a stop. That wasn't a full 60 mile per hour speed. We were doing about 57 when I hit it. I'll say this, give yourself the amount of time you would a half or three quarter ton pickup truck to brake in this thing. From here, turn on braking regeneration, and furthermore, you can go into settings. Man, that's so cool, the rocket in the background. And you can either have it on or on high. Now on, is a pretty strong regen. You take your foot off, and it kind of like gives it a really initial lurch, and then it hauls the vehicle down aggressively. High is even crazier. I mean, it is like something very heavy was just leveled on top of the Hummer EV to just stall us where we are. This takes some getting used to, not just because it's such strong regen braking, but because actually the very onset of the regen braking is a very big lurch. And that's kind of unusual as I've experienced EVs thus far. Even really strong regen braking EVs give you that little bit of ease into the beginning of the regen. This one, it's like, oh, you want regen? Take your foot off the throttle, you're stopping. Oh, that's something to know. For the paddle regen, it's not as strong. So for example, in the Cadillac Lyriq, when you use the paddle, it's actually stronger than the inherent regen settings. This paddle isn't as strong of regen as either the on or high settings. So it's sort of like another step for regen braking. And now with the most conservative expectations possible, I say, let's do a handling test in the Hummer EV pickup truck. In preparation, I'm gonna hit the traction control button once to turn traction off. And get on the brakes, turn in. Under the... You can almost cure the incredible understeer by getting back onto the power and pushing the rear end back around. Wow, okay. What you're really gonna have a hard time overcoming are the really knobby tires. So, yeah. The handling is not going to be incredible. You are going to be impressed by how flat it takes corners, the weight being so down low, but the nose does plow. And if you do have traction off, you can push it a little bit. Okay, that was good. Not as much fun and as agile as the Rivian R1T, but I expect if you replace the all-terrains with some all-season tires would be better. Anyway, just keep your expectations realistic and you'll be thoroughly impressed with the Hummer EV pickup. Now on the highway. We get quite a bit of wind noise. And those all-terrain tires are humming non-stop. This could get a little tedious if you had a long highway commute on your hands. It's bearable. The cabin still stays reasonably quiet so you can have a conversation with your passengers, but that wind noise is... it's pronounced. We do have Super Cruise that we can play around with, so I'll activate it here. And when the light goes green, it means I'm good to take off my hands. And I've experienced the system on a number of GM vehicles, each time being impressed with, one, how good it stays in the middle of the lane. Two, the auto lane change feature. So if I get up to a vehicle that's moving slower than the speed I've set, it will automatically look for an opening to my left, maneuver around the vehicle, and then get back into the lane I started in. Taking the curve beautifully. Very, very solid. So, Super Cruise, good. Wind and tire noise on the highway, not so great. We should talk pricing and competition now for this GMC Hummer EV pickup. Edition 1 is the only one they're doing deliveries of right now, and they're fully sold out. So unless you know a dealer with a hookup, you're kind of SOL. They are going to release EV3X, another tri-motor version of the Hummer, and EV2X and EV2, both dual motor versions of this vehicle, a little down the road. The EV2X is going to be $86,000. This Edition 1 is $110,000. The one I'm testing is about $115,000 with the off-road accessories we have equipped. You might compare it to vehicles like the Ford F-150 Lightning and the Rivian R1T. The reason you would is because they're the only other electric pickup trucks you can buy. The reason the comparison is kind of warped is that they're very much more traditional pickup trucks. Is the Hummer EV as good of a pickup as the Ford F-150 Lightning? No. Is it as sporty as the Rivian R1T? No. But is it trying to live up to those expectations or those of its lineage as a military vehicle, Humvee, turned H1, then H2, and it kind of just went down the rabbit hole from there? But it's not trying to be just a traditional pickup truck. It's trying to be something much, much crazier. Did you notice how we went under the overpass and then the screens went dark? I thought we were in night mode that quickly. Speaking of night, not to derail this too much, I will have a POV night drive for this truck. You'll get to hear the sound system. You won't have to hear me talking for 95% of the video. You can see the headlights. You can, all that good stuff. Let's hop back to the Lightning and R1T for just a sec to share some specifications. The F-150 Lightning, I'll just choose XLT extended range, and that one's $75,000 to start. It makes 563 horsepower, it gets to 60 in 4.5 seconds, and the range is 320 miles. The Rivian R1T starts at $79,500. It makes 835 horsepower. It gets to 60 in the same 3.3 seconds that Hummer says this Hummer EV pickup will do it. We saw 3.4. The range for the R1T in the large battery pack is 314 miles. They say there's a max battery pack coming with 400 miles. So that means that right now, the Edition 1 is the most expensive, it makes the most power, it's tied for quickest to 60, and it has the longest range. It also, I'm going to reiterate this, is different than the Lightning and the R1T. And if different is what you're going for, if you want some of that H1 mojo in a modern vehicle, you're not going to be satisfied with the Lightning and the R1T. They're both incredible pickup trucks. This is different and very, very special. It's not perfect. Some material quality in here I think is kind of cheap. The wind and tire noise is loud. It's very wide, hard to park. Not hard to maneuver though, not hard to drive. So quick, so much fun. It thrills me in a similar way that the kid version of me was thrilled by that H1. And I came in here going, there's no way. There's no way I'm gonna be as impressed with this as the little Miles sitting in the cabin of an H1, just poking around going, oh my gosh. That's what I sounded like. But I am. So well done, GMC. I hope you've enjoyed this PUV drive review. If you did, please like, comment, and share the video. Subscribe to the channel. Hit that bell to get notified. And I'll see you next time. Whee!